Namaskaram and hello to all our viewers everywhere. Welcome to our channel In Conversation with a Vagyekara with Guru Vagye Vidvanmani Sri N.C. Murthy. This is your host, Kiranmayi Gandhi. For those who have joined us newly, these episodes are a series devoted to discussing various aspects of Carnatic classical music as explained by a Vagyekara himself. It is a rare opportunity indeed. Today is episode 5 of our series. In the past two episodes, we have been talking about varnams with a focus specifically on Janaka Raga varnams, which are varnams in the 72 Melakartha Ragas of the Carnatic music scale. We have listened to the interesting and fascinating story of how Sri N.C. Murthy composed all the varnams in a short span of just 3 months. We have learned why it is important to master the 72 Melakartha Ragas to acquire better creativity in singing. We will further delve into this topic to know more. Guru Garu, namaskaram and welcome again. In our last conversation, you had explained to us how your Janakaraga Varnams are easy to learn and yet have a very lilting and scintillating flow, which makes the learning that much more enjoyable. And I wanted to ask talk about bhava in this episode. I guess that is also one of the important aspects when we sing, especially in music. So can you please let us know how an expression or a bhava can be conveyed, even if it is a singing of varnams?
Yeah. Thank you very much. I have told you in the earlier discussion also that I wanted to bring in the bhava aspect into the varnams so that we will be able to make the composition a little more meaningful composition. Mm-hmm. So the lyrical content has to be given a little more important. That's what I have endeavored. And so that's how all these varnams have little more lyrical content than the traditional varnams, so that the lyrics can be meaningfully heard when somebody renders. I'll give an example. I'll take a varnam in 2D of my Janakaraga Varnamanjari. The third varnam has again a thematic presentation, as I said. Na Samini Kantire Indaina Tadavaye Vani Kudi Vesariti Vega Sani Todi Teve. Now, Todi has a different meaning in the lyrics, but it also gives the Raga Mudra. That is the beauty. Mohana Murtre Asri Krishnumi. That is the lyrical content of the first part. Mm-hmm. After that, the gopi wonders, Ye gopi ke inta daginado. I'll say briefly explain to you in music how this sounds. Na sa mi ne kanti re na sa mi ne kanti re yadaina tadavaye vani gudi vesariti vega tani todite me mohana murti ni aati krishnu ni eko pikainta dagi nado eko pikainta dagi nado. It goes like this. So that's how we are able to understand the lyrical content. Mm-hmm. To apply the traditional vernums, we are able to see what is the content, what is the singer conveying. Mm-hmm. I will give you another example. Mm-hmm. It is in the raga Gayaka Priya. Okay? A Vivada Raga. Now, this is a generally established raga Todi. So therefore, you are able to put a lyrical content which is plausibly adjustable. Mm-hmm. But in a Vivada Raga, how does it come? Ramam Abhiramam. Now, this kind of Yuttugara itself is not there in any of the Prachin Varnams. Mm-hmm. This looks like it takes to you a meditative stage. Ramam Abhiramam Sita Bhama Samitam Sarvadharam Ramam Gunadamam Galalolam Jagaradadi Gayaka Priyam Vande. Is a different approach in a varna itself.
Yes. Okay.
And second thing, the Gayaka Priya Raga Mudra also has come. It, unlike the normal varnams which are little, you know, sung in a hurried fashion, this is a little slow tempo, at the same time getting into some kind of a meditative mood.
Yeah.
Okay. Then the Charanam says, Bhasam Srinivasam Shantamutim Bhasam Srinivasam Shantamutim Bhasam. So here you will find that vivadiness is not even felt.
Yes.
Although raga is vivadi raga, you don't feel that you have heard a vivadi raga.
Yeah.
So that is how the phraseology has been formed, so that vivadiness will not be very glaringly felt. Mm. It looks like a normal raga.
It does. Actually, you're true. I mean, I was able to learn these varnams from you. Guru Garu, that was a beautiful demonstration of the varnams, which includes the bhava, as you had said. And for our viewers, I'd like to just clarify that our guru is speaking about Vivadi Ragams. We'll devote a few episodes to Vivadi Ragams in the coming episodes as part of our series. That will definitely take its own place. So for today,
We will do that. You know, a little more elaborately about the Vivadi Ragas. But here, let us see, you know, we are talking about the bhava.
Bhava, yes.
Bhava also comes in this Vivada Ragas. Because it is already a known fact about the established normal ragas, how the bhava can be brought in.
Yes.
About Vivada Ragas, how the bhava can be easily brought in.
Mm.
I would like to show through a few examples.
Yeah, actually coming on that, we were talking about the thing that, speaking on bhava, what I'd like to interject and ask is, so that way
yes.
you can, is something that always keeps coming up as part of the traditional varnams that we learn. Music aspirants like me who have been through that and all across, after learning some varnams and a few kirtanams, they try to endeavor giving small concerts. And little into that journey, you know, people realize that they're not able to sing with a full expression, full bhava. And it's also a common experience that for the music aspirant that they feel that it takes a considerable amount of time to learn to sing with bhava. even after they start performing. So, you know, we have talked about this before, and I would like for our viewers to, hear from you. How is it that, or is there any way that your varnams can help alleviate this kind of glitch that they feel, or alleviate or help solve this problem?
Okay.
Yeah.
Now, as you know, I have written another book of varnams, which is called Bhava Raga Tala Varnams.
Mm-hmm.
There it is more clearly shown about how the normal established ragas also, the bhava can be brought in. Now, but since now we are talking about the Janaka Raga Varnams,
mm-hmm.
explain through a couple of Vivadi ragas particularly, because about normal ragas it is known how to bring in the bhava.
Okay.
So how to bring in the bhava in a Vivadi raga without letting other people know that it is a Vivadi raga, it is okay. So that is what I have tried to show in an example of a varnam in Mara Ranjani. Mara Ranjani is the 25th raga. Okay?
Yes. Okay.
That is again a Vivadi raga. Namana su telichi nannelava chitiva nachami. Is there, but it is not so much felt. Sami mahi mahi mani ne pogadamu Sri Madhav Dayamu. That is. Then here the Vivadi swaras are da and mi. So in Charanam I have shown mi cha ri ga ma ga ri cha ni da pa ta ma ga ri ga ma pa da mi cha. So Vivadinas is not so much felt. We have been able to break that monotony. Mi cha mi cha ri ga ma ga ri cha ni da pa Tamagiri gama pada chaati leeru meeku veeruvaru. So, the Vivadinas is not so much felt. Although Vivadinas is there, but it is not so much felt. I'll give you another example. Let's take the extreme example of a Vivadiraga, that is the Rasika Priya. Both Purvanga as well as the Uttaranga are Vivadi, and that also again it is a Pratimajma Raga.
Right.
Okay.
Yeah, 72nd Melakartha Raga.
72nd Melakartha Raga. So it is a Rasika Priya Raga. Okay.
Okay.
So I have chosen a romantic scenario. A lady singing for her lord. Yetani veche dira, yetani veche dira, ni kai chami, yuta bihu hilera, rasika priya pai, rasika priya. We have just broken that Rasika Priyapai. So that you know, when you put them together, the Rasika Priya name has also come.
Yes.
Inta bingu velera Rasika Priyapai. Vilta cheya pura viraha murvalera. Chuta cheri mega cheli ne ugora. Malmadagar Mugana Murti Malmadagar Mugana Murti. Now you are able to feel the bhava, the lyrical content.
Mm-hmm.
Although it is in a Vibhadraga. So that's how, these have been beautifully embedded. The lyrical content has been embedded to these ragas so that it is possible to give the bhava aspect in these words also.
Beautiful, beautiful. Guru Garu, thank you so much for being here and sharing your knowledge as usual with us. We were talking about, I think we have so much more to discuss about your varnams, more in detail about the Vivadi Ragams and other type of varnams that you've done too. So we will take a little bit more of that in the next episode. And again, thank you so much for being here. And viewers, thank you for taking the time to be here and listen in on our conversation. As usual, please do send in your comments and suggestions and questions you may have in the comment section below. Please like and share and subscribe to this channel. We hope to see you again in our next episode where I continue the conversation with the Vagyekara with my guru, Sri N.C. Murthy. Namaskaram and goodbye.